Welcome to the tutorial on how to organize an information retrieval task with our datasets in Tira. In this screencast, we will guide you to all the steps required to organize an information retrieval shared task in Tira, and we will just assume that we have already all the requirements fulfilled. The requirements in that case are that we reuse a Docker image that we have created in a previous tutorial, and this Docker image has an integration of a new small custom datasets to IR datasets. So basically what we did in this previous tutorial, this tutorial is linked here. I will just shortly recap everything. In this tutorial we have created an IR datasets integration for a new potential search engine for pangrams. So we created a set of pangram documents, so very short sentences, and we just want to search over those documents. That's the scenario. So we have also created some topics, and then we have bundled everything into an IR datasets integration and have builded this Docker image, and then we could run or export this Docker image locally as Tira would do it. So I just can re-execute this command. So this now uses the Docker image from the previous example and would execute the same command as Tira would execute, and this creates or imports the data as Tira would reuse it. So we have a set of documents and a set of queries and so on and so on. And Tira would now use the same image, or we want to now import the same image to Tira. So this was basically step zero of our current tutorial. So we need the Docker image with the IR datasets integration of our new shared task. So now that we have this image from the previous tutorial, if you have questions for that, just look into this detailed example. Everything is explained step by step. And now that we have fulfilled the requirements, so we have this Docker image, we can do the next thing, and we have to register to Tira. So you just have to create an arbitrary account. I, for example, have a test account that has no special rights or something like that, and I just log in and I now see basically the list of shared tasks, and that's it. So I have finished step one and have registered to Tira. The second step is to create an organization team that will organize the shared task. For that I just have to click on this organize task button, and here I have to create or specify some information of my of the organization that will organize a shared task. For example, I have to give my organization a name. I just use Tira tutorial, and we have to give some active years. So when is the organization active? We start just in 2023. We have to specify a website. We don't have a website, so we just leave this out. And if in case we would want to connect to a non-default Git backend, we can just add this here. But for the tutorial and for your first shared task, you can just use the default and leave those fields empty. With that, we can add the new task. And now I am part of an organization, so I now can add tasks and edit the organization. So basically, we have, for example, this Tira tutorial organization, and I could now also edit it in case I want to change something. Okay, just to explain this in a bit more detail. So in the background, Tira has now created a group for this Tira tutorial organization, and I am now the owner of this group. You can add offer users to this organization as you like. You can also just invite members and so on. So you have all the management functionalities. You have them all here. So in case you want to send one invite link or something like that, this is possible with this UI. But in most cases, it should be enough to add users or to remove members from the group if you like. So you can completely manage the members of your organization group. Yeah, now that we have this Jira tutorial organization, we can add a new task. And here I just have to add the name of the new task. We can call it, for example, Jira Tutorial IR Task. We have to specify an organizer that organizes this task. We are only members of the Jira Tutorial Group. We can also specify a web page, and we can give a description, just something like this is my tutorial. And with that, we can add this task. And here we have our new task, and that is already step three. So we have added the new task. As the next step, we have to add a new data set to the task. So I click on this shared task that we just have created. And this shared task has no data sets so far. So we can of course edit everything that we saw previously for this task, but what we want to do now is that we want to import a new data set, and because we want to organize an IR shared task, we just import a data set via this prepared Docker image for the IR data sets, for the IR data sets integration. So we have this Docker image that we saw previously that we have prepared, and I just have to paste this to the Docker image. And we also have to specify the ID of the data sets within this IR data sets in this installation in this Docker image. So that's it. We only have to specify the name, which is the ID in the IR data sets integration in this image. And then we can import this IR data sets data set, which usually takes a short amount of time. Yeah, what it does co now is it downloads the data and normalizes everything. And yeah, that's basically it. And the import was now successful. So we now have this data set here. Alright, we now have added this new data set, which is a training data set because we specified it as training data set during our import. We could also have said it is a test data set. The difference is that for training data sets, participants can directly see all the outputs, and for test data sets, participants by default do blinded experiments so that organizers have to unblind the results. So if you want to so in that case, it is a training data set so that participants can get their approaches to run and as easy as possible so that they directly see what the outputs and everything. But for the real final test data set, we would have to import this as test data. Alright, for this new data set, we now can also, of course, edit the data set, so we could rename it and all the stuff. We could also change the command that is executed in the image for the evaluation. So, for example, this command currently reports precision at 10, NDCG at 10, and mean reciprocal rank, but we could, of course, change this all here. So, this was basically the third step. So we have added our new task to Tira. The last step is to do some final end-to-end tests, and in that case, this means that we submit a first baseline or a first retrieval baseline for the task and see the results on the leaderboard and so on and so on. For that, I just click on submit. I'm now at the page for the task, and here I can click on Docker submission, and here I can have a dedicated installation or instructions on how to submit to my personal registry and so on. And what we can do now is we just can upload a new retrieval benchmark. So for example, we can use a retrieval benchmark with BEM25 with PyTerrier, and for that we just have to tag an existing image, for example. So we can run docker tag and then the image, and then the image how it should be named. So this is the name of the image, this is here, so it would be something like this, and here we specify a name, for example PyTerrier 001, and that's it. So this is now the image that participant would create. We just reuse an existing baseline, and we now just can push this as we would push it to any arbitrary Docker registry, but it is now our own registry to which only we have access. So, and all of this is explained in detail in this description here. So, we have uploaded an image. Okay, and here we just refresh the images and select the image that we just have uploaded. So this PyTerrier 001 thing created just now. And we have again to specify a command that is to be executed in this image. And here we just can use a prepared command. That's this one. And then we can add this container, which creates and adds a new tab here. And now that we have this, we can directly run it. For this image or for this software that we have created, we can never change the command or the image, and because this is immutable. And we now can just say that we ran it. So we have this pangram dataset, and we specify the resources on which it should run. We can also run it multiple times. So I now run it, for example, with one CPU core and 10 gigabytes of RAM. This is now started. I can run it as well with, for example, two CPU cores and so on. And this runs now, or this should start, the second process should also start immediately. One could also run it, for example, on a GPU or something like that, but this is not required, of course, for BEM25. And yeah, this just takes now a short amount of time to get scheduled in the cluster, and then it runs in the cluster and is finally evaluated. Yeah, I skipped a bit. We now have one software already executed. The other software is currently the execution of the software is finished, so it did some BEM25 retrieval. We see everything because it is a training dataset on a test dataset. We would not see outputs, and it is currently in the evaluation process, so building the evaluation. And for the run, that is already finished. We can see everything, so we can see the evaluation, we can see the output of the software, the files, we could download it, and of course we can also reveal this to participants, and we now would also already have this on the leaderboard and so on. Yeah, that's basically it. So that was the last step of this tutorial. We saw how we can organize an shared task in information retrieval with TIRA, with IR datasets. And what we basically did was we had to register to TIRA, we added an organization team, we added a task, then we added a dataset. And the interesting thing was that we added this dataset with the IR datasets integration. And with that, we can use re-ranking approaches and so on. And we saw in the final end-to-end test that we have executed some retrieval methods on this new dataset, and this produced in the end new run that we can look into or that we already also evaluate. That was the tutorial. Thank you for your attention.